for you. And that's been the best grace, is what you are thinking about today, so that your name and your kept in the kingdom. The Lord Jesus, again, Pharisees. Now, this is everybody can do this. Pay tithes of corn, animals, and pay tithes of everything that you have. But you have limited the weight here in the presence of the Lord. The most important, people don't understand what I say. This is indispensable. What I say, this is essential. What I say, this is important. And what I say, this is the non-essential. This one is just, you know, like nothing to think about. You don't understand. That's what Jesus spoke about. That's what Jesus said. There are some things that are weightier than others, more important than others. And many people of the world do things that are very important and weightier. And then they just look at those and essential things that can be without the grace of God. Then he says, when we meet the weightier matters of the Lord, judgment, mercy, and faith. Those that you have done and not to leave the other undone. I'm talking to you from the word of God and the way into the kingdom of God. The way into the kingdom of God. When you came at Matthew again, Matthew chapter 4. That's where we started. Matthew chapter 4. And we're reading from verse 17. Matthew chapter 4, verse 17. From that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God, is at hand. Repent, so that you'll be able to get to God's kingdom. Repent before we pray. Number one, repentance and faith before entering the kingdom. Repentance and faith before entering the kingdom. Number two, righteousness and faithfulness expected in the kingdom. Righteousness and faithfulness expected in the kingdom. Number three, responsibility of fruit bearing for the kingdom. Responsibility of fruit bearing for the kingdom. Number one now, repentance and faith before entering the kingdom. Mark chapter 1. Here are the words of Jesus Christ himself. Mark chapter 1, verses 14 and 15. Now, after that, John was put in prison. Jesus came into Galilee preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God, preaching the good news of the kingdom of God, preaching the good tidings of the kingdom of God, and saying, the time is fulfilled. Anyone can enter to the kingdom now. The time is here. The time of the kingdom, the door is open. How do we enter? Repent ye, number one, and believe the gospel, number two. Repent, but I must stop there and believe. Believe that must not stand in isolation. You must repent. Those must go together, repenting and believe the gospel. Luke chapter 13, reading from verse 1. There were present at that season some that told him of the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. And Jesus answered, says unto them, suppose you that these Galileans were sins above all the Galileans, because they suffered such things. As you think about the world in which you live, you hear that calamities happen in some places, some terrible things, such things happen in some places, and then you say, praise the Lord, I'm still alive. He says, yes, you're alive, but you think that these people that suffered such things are more sinners than you are. It says, I tell you nay, but except you go want, except you repent, sacrifice is not enough, bring your animals not enough, I'm worrying this, I'm not worrying that not enough. I'm religious, that's not enough. I go to the temple, that's not enough. I give tithes of what I possess, that's not enough. I have good works, that's not enough. Except you repent, you shall have one night once perish. Of those 18, verse 4, upon whom the tower of Sidon fell, as soon then, thinking ye that they were sinners above all me that went to Jerusalem, I tell you nay, but except you repent, ye shall all likewise perish. The Lord is saying that even the sacrifice on the cross of Calvary is not enough. Even the love of God is not enough to accommodate you, bring you in, except you repent. There's something to do. God said, you have the world again, the same begotten Son, that whosoever believes in me should not perish, but have everlasting life. But you must do something. Come into the kingdom. You must repent. Except you repent, you shall not likewise perish. Is that for the people at that time only? Look at Luke chapter 24. Luke chapter 24. And he from verse 4 to 6 and said unto them, thus it is written, and thus it behoved Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day. This is talking after Jesus Christ rose from the dead. Now Christ has died for our sins. That's great. And he was buried for 3 days. That's wonderful. And he rose again the third day. Doesn't that get everybody saved? Whether they do anything or not, doesn't that get everybody into the kingdom? Because Christ has died, was buried, and rose again. Look at this. And that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name. This was after the resurrection, after he paid the price for salvation. And Jesus said, repentance must be preached. And remission of sins, we go together. Repentance first, and then the forgiveness of sin, preached in his name, among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. You see that? Among all nations, the ones that repentance preach. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 17, verse 13. Acts chapter 17, verse 13. Here we're told in verse 13. It says that in terms of ignorance, that this ignorance, God went out. But now, at this time, now, after the cross, now, after the resurrection, now that Jesus ascended into heaven, now, this day of grace, this dispensation of grace, now, commanded, how many people, where, everywhere, to do what? To repent. Have you had those people that just preach after they preach no repentance? It doesn't say you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. He died for everybody on the cross of Calvary. You believe raise up your hand and raise up your hands. You don't have to give up their smoking, their drinking, their adultery, their fornication. Just believe, just believe. And as you believe, they say, praise the Lord. Look at all those people. They say, I want to assure you, you're already in the kingdom. It doesn't matter what you do, it doesn't matter what you have done. You don't have to repent. You don't have to do anything. Christ died for you. But Jesus himself said, after he rose from the dead, that repentance and remember of sin, remission of sin should be preached in his name. In all nations, then it says so that he commands all men everywhere to repent. Because in the sight of one, he has appointed a day in the which he will judge the world in righteousness by that man whom he has ordained, whereof he has given assurance unto all men, in that he has raised him from the dead. We're looking at chapter 20 of Acts. Acts chapter 20.
Even that you have been blessed with this powerful message. Our address is at the bottom of the screen. I believe you will join us one of this Sunday to worship together. Thank you. God bless you. Let us pray. Our mighty Father, we glorify your name and thank you, Lord, because of this powerful message. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you will touch those people who are in need of salvation, those people who are in need of prosperity, those people who are in need of healing, and by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, they will give testimony because of this message. In Jesus' name we pray.
You are my God. Say it one more time, say, oh, 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 Lord.